This comes from Pro Football Focus, Dalton, and there's some narratives that they think are going around right now about certain prospects, and they want to debunk them. The first of which is in regards to the quarterbacks, and the narrative is that Trey Lance from North Dakota State is a developmental quarterback, while Mac Jones is quote-unquote pro-ready. Now, both of these guys have 17 starts under their belt, whereas, you know, Trey Lance is in the FCS, but Mac Jones is in the SEC, so I guess he gets the nod there. But it's not like either one of these guys has played a ton of games. And so the narrative that Trey Lance is a developmental quarterback while Mac Jones is pro-ready, and Pro Football Focus is not necessarily discounting the fact that Trey Lance is a bit of a developmental quarterback and would probably benefit from a redshirt year with whatever team that drafts him. But they're more wondering, like, why is Trey Lance the developmental quarterback while Mac Jones is considered super pro-ready, and the Niners are giving up a bunch of draft picks to go up to number three to select him, even though he's barely played much football either?
Yeah, I mean, I think that this kind of comes from, first of all, Mac Jones was there and at Alabama this entire time. So he did have the experience of going through the practices and getting reps in that way. And I think that that's the way that a lot of people look at it. Also, being at the SEC level and not the FCS level is something that I think teams take into account as well. Plus, just with the nuance of the Alabama offense and how well Mac Jones was able to get the ball out of his hands quickly to his playmakers. And, you know, a lot of that is just the genius of Steve Sarkisian, but he was also good in that area as well. I also don't believe the narrative surrounding Trey Lance being this huge project, because I don't think that he is. Although that offense is a little bit old school in heavy personnel, heavy play action, I mean, he would be a great fit in Kyle Shanahan's scheme. Played under center a lot, played, you know, that heavy play action role. I think that that would be a decent fit for Trey Lance overall. And so I think that the developmental thing and making checks and, you know, pass blocking checks and things of that nature, he was involved in all of that. So Trey Lance had a lot on his plate for a young player. I think it just comes down to the FCS level thing.
Yeah, and the turnovers
and
is
the
one
age.
Thing. The age, okay, but the turnover-worthy plays was an interesting graphic that they put up in the article here. The fewest turnover-worthy plays in a season, according to Pro Football Focus, for the 2021 draft class. Zach Wilson has the fewest, 365 dropbacks with only four turnover-worthy plays,
whoa,
according to PFF. But Trey Lance comes in at number two.
You know, look Dalton gave in the fan cam there.
There might be a couple more than four, but it's not, honestly, it's not too many more than that. And, you know, a lot of people talk about Trey Lance and the zero interceptions that he threw in 2019. He might have thrown a little bit more than five as well that were turnover worthy, that were just dropped or, you know, it was a miscommunication with the wide receiver and, you know, it went through the hands of the defender or the defender stopped with the wide receiver. And so there were a couple of turnover worthy plays, but Trey Lance does do a very good job of taking care of the football. And I think that, you know, all of these quarterbacks actually in the top five do a really good job of overall taking care of the football.
So one other thing when it comes to Trey Lance, we get, and this happens a lot on the Autoflex Leasing fan text, right? With Justin Fields being from Ohio State, and you have not had a good history of quarterbacks coming out for the Buckeyes, whether it is, you know, R.J. Barrett, recently Dwayne Haskins, Braxton Miller, etc. Alabama, similar deal. Maybe Tua changes that narrative, but Alabama hasn't had a successful quarterback come out in a long time. Has Carson Wentz and his downslide in recent years hurt Trey Lance at all? Is that potentially something teams might be viewing with that North Dakota State connection?
I don't think so, because the list is shorter with North Dakota State. It is just Carson Wentz. And the NFL has seen Carson Wentz play at, you know, an MVP level. It was just a lot of unsustainable third down play. But you've seen the high end of what Carson Wentz was before he kind of just absolutely fell off in this past season. And so I think that they're not going to hold that against Trey Lance as much as, you know, they might hold it against, you know, somebody like Justin Fields, especially. And it's funny that you talked about the Alabama thing, because you're not hearing that narrative with Mac Jones, which is shocking to me. And I don't really understand it, because
It's dumb either way. It's dumb both ways.
No, it's absolutely dumb. I'm trying to rack my brain for why they're doing it with Justin Fields at Ohio State and not Mac Jones at Alabama, even though, you know, one of them has an offense that changed completely for their skill set, and that is Justin Fields. The Ohio State offense under Urban Meyer, under JT Barrett and Dwayne Haskins, it was a bunch of mesh concepts, throwing the ball on short crossers, getting it to their playmakers, allowing them to make plays after the catch. And Justin Fields leads this group of quarterbacks in pass yard percentage after yak. So he throws the ball downfield more and creates less yak because of the way that his offense goes. There is a lot of downfield throws in Justin Fields' offense. And so it's weird, because that's not the same Ohio State offense. So you could see that this is kind of the same offense that Tua Tagovailoa ran with Mac Jones. And so if there's anybody that should be getting that, like, school, you know, helmet sticker narrative, it should be on Mac Jones and not Justin Fields. But it really, obviously, shouldn't be either of them.